Good morning, children. I expect that everyone is enjoying Corona holidays. But today onwards, we are going to start our 6th class. So in 6th class, we are going to start our mathematics with the first chapter, Knowing Our Numbers. Knowing Our Numbers means already we know that we discussed a lot of numbers in previous classes. So the numbers are very huge numbers are there, up to infinity are there. They start from 1 to infinity are there. But we have to know about more about our numbers, what are the rules and regulations, how we are going to knowing more and more about them. So in this chapter we are going to learn about our comparing numbers first, and second is shifting digits, and third one is rounding of numbers, place values, use of commas, larger numbers using in our daily life, and use of brackets, and how to use the Roman numbers. So first of all, coming to the comparing numbers. So these comparing numbers are nothing about ascending order and descending order mainly. So ascending order, descending order. So everyone knows that ascending order means smaller number to bigger value, and descending order means bigger to smaller. So this is already you know, well known about this ascending order, descending order. But here another way of comparing numbers is with the three symbols. The first symbol is greater than symbol. The greater than symbols look like this, and the less than symbol. So less than symbol looks like this, and third one is equal symbol. Equal symbol. So by these three symbols we are going to compare the numbers. How we are going to compare the numbers? For example, if you take two numbers, 7, 6, 8, 9, and one more number is 7, 6, 7, 7. So in these two numbers, which number is bigger? Everyone knows that which number is bigger means 7689 is bigger than the 7677. But how to compare? How to check? So we have to go through this one with the right to left. First of all, we have to check from right side to left side. So first of all, see here, in the right side starting digit is 7, and in this number starting is 7. So these both are same, so we can't tell them which one is bigger, which one is smaller. Next one, check the next digits. So next digit is 6 and next digit is 6. So these also both are same, so here also we can't tell the which one is bigger. So next, coming to third digit is 8, and here third digit is 7. So see here, 8 is bigger than the 7. So this total number is greater than this total number. So for suppose we can take one more number, one more example. For suppose we can take 6, 7, 6, 8, 9, 7, 6, 8, 10. So here observe that everyone, here there are only 4 numbers, here total, here only there are 4 digits, but here there are 5 digits. Of course this is the bigger one. So in this case, see here, this one is smaller than this one. So 7689 is less than 76,890. So next, one more third example we can take, 896 and 896. If we see both three digits, here both these three digits are equal. So we can tell these two numbers are equal. So this is the way of comparing digits. And also we can see one more example, how to write the group of numbers by using these symbols. For suppose if they give for us 26, 27, 36, 37, 40. These are the group of numbers they given for us. For this we have to, they give us write down with ascending order including symbols. So first of all, for this what we have to do? Ascending order. Ascending order. What is the ascending order? Means small to big. In this total numbers, which is the smaller one? 26 is the smaller one. Next smaller number is 27. Next smaller number is 36. Next smaller number is
37. Next one is 40. So in this, how to use the symbol? How to use the symbol? 26 is less than 27. So here put the less than symbol. Next, 27 is less than 36. So we can put here less than symbol. 36 is less than 37. So 37 is less than 40. So same like this, we have to use descending order. We have to write the descending order. Means, first of all, write down the descending order is big to small. 40, 37, 36, 27, 26. So 40 is greater than the 37. So greater, we have to use the greater than symbol. So 37 is greater than 36. 36 is greater than 27. 27 is greater than 26. So like this, we have to use ascending order and descending order with the symbols. With the symbols. So this is the way of comparing numbers. So next our topic is shifting the digits. Shifting the digits means nothing but very simple. What is the shifting the digits means? In their view for us, digits they will give. What they will give? Digits. For suppose they will give digits 1, 0, 9, 4. These 4 digits they given us. By using these 4 digits, we have to make the numbers. We have to make the numbers. So, if they ask, make the numbers, make the, by using these 4 digits, make the 4 digit number. Making the 4 digit number. So, how to make the number now? What are the numbers possible by these 4 digits? The first one is, so don't write 0 on the right side. Why? Because it is not valid putting the 0 on the right side. We have to always put in the 1 digit letter only. So, first of all, we have to take the smallest digits. 1. Next smallest is 0, 4, 9. This is 1 number. Next one is 1, 4, 0, 9. Next one is 1, 4, 9, 0. See here. We completed one order. One by one. Next, which is the biggest? After 1, what is the biggest one? 4. So, 4. Next, 1, 0, 9, 4, 0, 1, 9, 4, 9, 0, 1, 4, 4, 0, 9, 1. So like this of writing the numbers by using these 4 digits, by using 4 digits, we can make so many numbers. What are the possible numbers we have to write down? We can write down here. So this is the shifting the digits. Shifting the digits. This is the shifting the digits topic. So next, coming to the very very important thing, rounding of numbers. Rounding of numbers. So what is the rounding of numbers? So this rounding of numbers is very very useful in our daily life. Why? Because in more shops, whenever we are going to shops, there we get, for suppose we get 369 rupees bill. 369 rupees bill we get. But they will collect from us 370 rupees approximately. Approximately or nearby, what is the nearby number? They will collect that one. They will not give like that only. This is rounding of numbers. How we have to round up the numbers? What is the use of this round up numbers? Means approximate values. So, for suppose we have the number 489. What is the nearest value of 10? Nearest rounding of 10 for this means 490. 490. Observe here. These two digits observe here. What is this here? 89. So what is the nearest one? This one is 90. Or we can write, which is the nearest 100 of this one means, we can write 500. Nearest 100. Nearest 10 means we have to take the tens. We have to only change the tens places. Up to tens places. Or we have to write the 100. Nearest 100 means we have to write the 500. First, suppose, how to take the approximate values? The any value is in between 0 to 4. In between 0 to 4, we have to take 0. the day 0. In between 6 to 9, you have to take the 10. So, but in the middle we have 5. If we have 5, we have to take the bigger value only, 10.
That is depends on our consideration.
So this is the rounding of the values. In this we have the two forms. One is rough estimation and one is closer estimation. So what is the rough estimation? What is the closer estimation? For suppose they will give us the values are 480, 489, 396, 225. These are the numbers we have. For these numbers we have to tell them what is the rough estimation. So what is the rough estimation means? 225. What is the rough estimation? What is the 225 means? We can take 200 nearest 100. Next, 480 means we can take 500. 489 means also we can take 500. What is 396 means we can take 400. By adding all these things, 500 plus 200, 700. 700 plus 500, 1200. 1200 plus 400, 1600. So this is the rough estimation. What is the closer estimation? What is the closer estimation means? We have to take the tens places. What is the closer estimation of 225 means? We can take 230 plus. What is the 480 means? 480 only. What is the rough estimation of 489 means? 490. What is the rough estimation of 396 means? You can take 400. So now we can add it. 230 plus 480. 230 plus 480. So that is 8 plus 3. 11. 4 plus 2, 6 plus 7. Plus 490. Plus 400. Next. 710 plus 490, this is 0, 0, 0. 9 plus 1, 10. 7 plus 4, 11. 11 plus 1, 12. Plus 400. So what we are getting? 1600. So in this situation we got rough estimation as a 1600 and the closer estimation also 1600. But in some situations we will get the difference also. Like this of problems we will get in the exercises also. Next, so this is all about the rounding of numbers. We are observing in two ways. One is rough estimation and closer estimation. Next topic is place values. These place values are two types. One is Indian place value system. One is International place value system. So what is the international value system? What is the Indian place value system? First of all, we learn about the Indian place value system. For suppose we have any number, any bigger number, how to read the place values? For suppose we have 7108923170. This total is one number. In this, how to read the place values? Everyone knows that the starting from left to right. So this is the ones place. Next, tens place, hundreds place, thousand place, 10,000 place, lakhs place, 10 lakhs place. Crores, 10 crores, next 100 crores. 100 crores is the bigger, 100 crore is the bigger place value and smaller one is the ones place. This ones place we can known as a unit place also. We can read it as a unit place also. So that is ones place, tens place, 100 place, 1000 place, next 10,000 place value, next lakhs, 10 lakhs.
Next, crore, 10 crore. Next is 100 crores. This is Indian place value system. Everyone knows that from your third class, fourth class onwards, daily you are learning about this Indian place value system. Better on. So, now we are going to discuss about the international place value system. What is this international place value system? Where it will be useful? International place value system. International place value system. What is this international place value system? I will give one good example for you. For suppose, in our class, we want to go another countries. I am from India and one more Shiva is there. Shiva is from America. Later on, I am going to meet Shiva. So here I will tell him when we are discussing, suddenly I required some amount from him. Then I will ask him, give me 1 lakh rupees. Give me 1 lakh rupees. Then suddenly that reply from Shiva is, what is what? Lakhs? What is this lakhs? So they don't know what about the lakhs and what about these things. So in international wide, we can't use some places, some values. So international, how we have to read and how we have to know is, the first one, for suppose we can take any number, 901902069789. So this is the one number we have to divide in the international place value system. In international place value system and also in the Indian place value system, the starting three place values are very same. The starting three place values are same. That means this is ones place, this is tens place, and this is hundred place. These three are in both systems same. These three are both in both systems same. Coming to next one also same. This is thousands place. That is thousands place. Next one is 10,000 place, and this is not lakhs one, this is 100,000 place. 100,000 place, and this is million. What is that? Millions place value. And next one is 10 millions. Next one is 10 millions. Next one is 100 millions. 100 millions. Next one is billion. 10 billion. 100 billion. 100 billion. So like that it will increase. So in international place value system and international place value, in Indian place value system, 100 crores is the bigger one. Here, in international place value system, billion is the bigger one. Billion after 10 billion, 100 billion, next to trillion, 10 trillion, 100 trillions, it will come very huge. But everyone will use up to billions. Up to billions. How we in Indian system we are using up to crores. In international they will use up to billions. So here we observe. When I ask Shiva 1 lakh rupees, that means in international system how much? 100,000. 100,000. So this is the difference between Indian place value system and also the international place value system. Next, how to use commas? How to use commas in Indians and in international? So, suppose we will take one number 920123456790. This is one number. First of all, we will see how to write in an Indian system. How to use commas in a Indian system. So in Indian system or international system, the starting one first unit is the three. Ones place, tens place, hundreds place. This is the first unit. This we call as a first unit. So after three digits, we will put first comma. After first comma. In Indian system, what is the second unit means? Second unit. That is 1,000 and 10,000. So after this one, we will put one comma, after two digits. That like this, of every unit, we will put the commas.
So this is lakhs, 10 lakhs. Next crore, 10 crore, 100 crore.
100 crore.
This is the third unit and this is the fourth unit. So like this in Indian system, in the starting three units we will put one comma, next after that, after two digits, after two digits, after two digits, we will put the commas in Indian system. In Indian system. Like this, we will take same in international system. So first of all, we will take one more example. 10209435226. So in international system. International system. So here also the first unit is 1's unit, 100's unit, 10's units and 100 units. This is the first unit. So we will put here one comma. Next unit is 1000, 10,000, 100,000. So here after three digits we will put the comma. Next is million, 10 million, 100 million. So in international system we will put after three digit ones. After three digit ones. This is the use of commas. So next, larger numbers using in our daily life. What is this larger numbers in using in our daily life? What is this?
Our topic is now use of commas is over. Now next one is larger numbers using on our daily life. So what is the larger numbers using in our daily life? Is nothing but when we are going to for markets or when we are going to travel anywhere, what we are going to use the word, that is measurements. What is that? Measurements. Mass units. What is that? Mass units. So, if you want to travel somewhere, what the we will use that? Kilometers, meters, that means in the length we will calculate. So, that length we will calculate in the first of all meters. First of all in the meters. So, 1 meter is equal to how much? 1000 millimeters. So, this 1000 millimeters will be converted into 100 centimeters and one more is as a decameters. One more is as a decameters. So, once the meter will be converted into meters, 1 meter. So, 1 meter equals 1000 millimeters. When we call as a 1000 meters, when we will consider 1000 meters, it will become the 1 kilometer. When we will come the 1000 meters, it will consider as a 1 kilometer. So, this is the length measurements. Next, coming to weight. When we are going to for market to purchase any vegetables or like that, we will calculate them in the kgs and grams. So, that means 1 kg equals to 1000 grams. 1 gram equals to 1000 milligrams. So next, if you want to purchase any water or milk, anything, we will calculate them in a volume. Volume is nothing but liters or kiloliters. 1 liter is equals to 1000 milliliters or 1 kiloliter equals to 1000 liters. Next, one more larger value number is time. Time is nothing but, everyone knows that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds, 1 hour equals to 60 minutes. 24 hours is equals to 1 day equals 24 hours, 1 year equals to 366 days, 1 leap year equals 365 days. Like that, we will consider the larger numbers in the small units. So, larger numbers using our daily life means we are considering the bigger values in a smaller one, bigger values in a smaller days. So, in this section, we are going to see the more about the word problems. Word problems. Word problems is nothing but whenever you are going to market, they will purchase 2 kg of potatoes or 3 kg tomato or 500 grams chili. Like that, we will use some matter and here we have to add it. How many? Total. What is the total weight? Total weight. How to add this one? 2 kg plus 3 kg plus 500 grams. That means here is the smaller value. So that's why we have to convert this 2 kgs and 3 kgs into the grams. 1 kg equals to how many grams? 1 kg equals to how many grams? 1000 grams. Like that, 2 kgs equals to how much? 2000 grams. Plus, like that, 3 kg means 3000 grams plus 500
grams. Total how much? 2000 plus 3000, 5000. 5000 plus 500, 5500 grams. That means we can convert them into the smaller value means 5 kg, 5.5 or 5 kg, 5.500 kgs will come. That means in a smaller value how much will come? 5.5 kgs. 5.5 kgs we can consider. 5.5 kgs. So like this we will use the larger numbers in a smaller way and smaller way into the larger way. So this is simple about the larger numbers. When we are discussing about word problems in this chapter, at the time you will understand the better and how to do and how the larger numbers will use in our daily life. So next our topic is using of brackets. Using of brackets, everyone knows that the well-known topic from your childhood. How to add, how to subtract, how to multiply, how to divide by using the Bartmas rule. By using Bartmas rule. What is this Bartmas rule? Bracket of division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. Bracket of division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. For suppose if they will give any problem like this, 9 plus 3 into 5 divided by 9 minus 2. Like this they will give. What we have to do first? We have to solve what is there in the brackets. What is there in the brackets? That means 9 plus 3 into 5, 3 5 is 15, divided by 9 minus 2. Minus 2. Next, bracket is over. Next one is division. We have to divide 15 by 9. 15 by 9 how much will come? 15 by 9 how much will come? That means 15 by 9 means it will come like something 1.333 something it will come. Continuous it will come. Why? Because it is not divisible exactly. Next, minus 2. Next, again we have to do addition and again subtraction. 9 minus 1.3 means 8.777 something and minus. Again last subtraction. Subtraction. So something like this we have to follow the use of brackets. That means whenever they give the problems like this, first of all we have to solve in the brackets one. This is the use of brackets. First of all we have to solve it. What is there in the brackets? Next. So the next topic is Roman numbers. In this Roman numbers, why they are using these Roman numbers means before there is no pattern for numbers. The Roman people are using the letters. By using the letters they will represent the numbers. So how they will represent means they will represent the numbers in a by using 7 digits, 7 symbols, that is 7 alphabets. The first alphabet is I, the second one is V, the third one is X, the fourth one is L, and fifth one is C, and sixth one is D, and seventh one is M. So what the numbers represent? This I is nothing but 1, I is nothing but 1, and V is nothing but 5, and X is nothing but 10, and L is nothing but 50, and C is 100, and D is 500, and M is 1000. So these alphabets will represent with the this number pattern. So next, so now how they will use? For suppose we have to write 1, we have to write 1, we will write the I, we will write the I. And for suppose we have to write 2, means we will write the 2 i's. 2 i's. And for suppose we have to write 3, we have to write 3 1's. 3 i's. And for suppose we have to write 4, we don't want to write I as a 4 times, that is wrong. Why? Because I will tell you rules. And we have to write 1. And see, observe here, this V represents 5 and 1 represents. And this I represents 1. 5 minus 1, 4. And next, 5 represents with V. and 6 represents with 5 plus 1 and 7 represents 5 plus 1 plus 1, 8 represents 5 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 and 9 represents 1 minus, see here, x is nothing but 10, 10 minus 1, 9 and 10 is nothing but x. So observe here numbers, there is a some different kind of confusion in your minds. What is there here? Sir, first here I means 1 we used and here 2 means 2 I's we used and 3 means 3 I's we used. But when you are coming 4, why you written like this 5 minus 1? That means there is a rule of Roman number, that is don't repeat any number 3 times more than. Don't repeat more 3 times more than. So for suppose here we use already 1, 2, 3, 3 times only we use, right or wrong? That means when we are adding the Roman numbers, we have to use the symbol only 3 times. Or when we are subtracting, we have to subtract only 1 time or 2 times. Like that only we have subtracted the 5 minus 1, we get the 4. And here also see, observe here 6, 5 plus 1 and 7, 5 plus 1 plus 1, 7, 8, 5 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, 8. Next 9, we subtracted from the 10, So this is the using of Roman numbers, and in this, don't repeat 2 times or 3 times, which order is, this 5 and D, don't repeat this 2 symbols more than 2 times, For suppose, we have to write 70, what is the nearest one, this one here, L, L plus 10, for suppose 80 means, L means 50, plus X plus X plus X, how much will come, 80, for suppose 90, we will write L into X plus X plus X plus X. It is correct? No. It is wrong. Why? Because here we are using 4 times the symbol. This is wrong. We have to use only 3 times. Right or wrong? So that means 90, how will we write 90? That means we have to subtract from 100. That means X, L. X, C. C means 100. 100 minus 10, 90. 100 minus 10, 90. Right or wrong? Next 100 is write like this. So these are the rules behind this writing when we are writing the Roman numbers. But nowadays we are not using these Roman numbers. Why? For suppose we have an example. L X X plus X C plus D X plus M. To add this one, how much time it will take? See, first of all, we have to expand it. The normal form. L X X means 50 plus 10 plus 10, 70. Plus 90. This is bigger value before, no? That means C minus 100 minus 10, 90. Plus DX means 50 plus 500 plus 10, 510 plus 1000. After this, we are getting to possible to add here. Directly, it is possible to add here? No. That's why we are using our number systems only. And here, any symbol, the less symbol is writing before bigger value, that is the subtraction. Or any symbol is writing bigger value after, that is the addition. So this is all about simple about the Roman numbers. Already we discussed this Roman numbers, how to add, how to subtract, how to multiply in 5th class and 4th class. But in 6th class, there is no any problems on the Roman numbers. Just they given to remember us about these Roman numbers. So this is all about our knowing our numbers in 6th class. This is all the topics. These are all the topics we are going to observe, and we are going to solve the exercise problems in this knowing our numbers. So my dear children, this is all about our the first chapter. So this is all about the our first chapter. So now if we have any doubts, regarding of any topic here, so please you can contact me by calling my number. And you can call by number, my number, and also you can call, you can do WhatsApp also. If you have any doubts, you can do WhatsApp for this same number. Okay, and now I am going to send you the introduction of this chapter. Please write down, please make a maintain a good notebook, a new notebook also, no problem. We have to write down all this introduction, and I will send you exercises in your WhatsApp. Please do it that problem. If you have doubts in that one, so please send that doubts to me. And first of all, when you are doing that exercise problems, first of all do in a rough work. If it is correct, totally is correct, then copy it into the notebook. Don't do it direct in the notebook. So thank you. Have a nice day.